Right. Hello, everyone, and welcome to my very first live video. I know it's probably going to not be as good as some of the other videos I've done, and I may mess up quite a bit, but hopefully it will turn out okay. So as you can tell by the title, this is a Q&A video. 700 subscribers. Well, actually, it's 708. So, yeah. I'm sorry. I am trying to figure all of this out right now. So I'm just playing around some of the stuff, because this is my first live video, so yeah. Wait, how do I turn on the chat option? Oh, it's right here. Okay. All right, so if you guys have any questions you want to ask me, then just go ahead and watch and send them in. I'm just going to pop on over here where I have some questions here. And we'll start with the first one. Okay, so our first question is, do you follow a fixed process when creating characters, or is it more spontaneous or variable? Usually if I watch a movie and I'm inspired by it, then I'll create a character or an OC based off of something I've watched. So the vampire audio, I may have mentioned this before, but I'm a big Twilight fan. I watch it all the time with my mom, so I sort of wanted to create a vampire OC. And as for the the Space Pirate one. Well, people have done Space Pirate audios before, and I was hoping to maybe create one. Plus, I also like Pirates of the Caribbean, so it's heavily based off of that. I'm doing very well, thank you, Pacha. By the way, love your icon. It's perfect. But yeah, for creating characters, it's basically something I come up with just out of the blue, but of course I have to carefully plan them out. And yeah. Okay, so are you also into tabletop role-playing? I don't do tabletop role-play, but I do a lot of role-play on like Instagram or Tumblr or whatever. I do a lot of stuff for movies and that. Also, there's my dog barking. She makes a lot of cameos in my videos. Okay, our next question is, I don't know if I asked this before, but do you have a mini-series? Well, in addition to working on the vampire series, which I'm in the process of coming up with the next video, I want to sort of do a continuation off of the schoolgirl audio that I did, and you'll have to wait and see for that one, because that's the next video and I don't want to spoil it. So, but I also want to continue the Space Pirate one, but I'm on a little bit of a writer's block right now. Plus, I'm working on 2 fan fictions, well, actually 3. And I'm working on writing on, I'm sorry, I can't speak. I'm very nervous right now. This is my first live stream. So, what was I saying? I'm so sorry, you guys. Okay. Oh, and I'm working on my own book. Yeah. I'm gonna be an author. So, yeah, that's kind of what I've been doing. So the script creating process has been a little bit of a slow thing, so yeah. But I hope to make a lot more series in the future. Okay, this question is, what prompted you to start making YouTube videos? I actually got this question a little while back, but basically, I saw a lot of people doing voice acting on YouTube, and I thought, well, since I like writing and since I like acting things out, maybe I could try it. And honestly, I didn't think I would do this well. I thought the first week I would just be done with it and it wouldn't be my thing and I'd just move on. But it turns out that it's pretty fun. Plus, it's kind of like role playing. It's kind of like acting. So you're doing fine. Thank you. Thank you. I haven't like, usually when I talk, when I'm recording, I can just erase all the hiccups in my audios. Trust me, sometimes it'll take me like 2 hours just to record 8 minutes. And I'm not kidding. Also, my programs for making videos decided to fluctuate. So yeah, that's something else, but yeah. I know I'll get it back on track eventually. Alright, so it doesn't look like we have too many questions here, but if you want to go ahead and ask me something, we can do that. Just go on my little... Just wait, hold on. Yeah, let's just go back here. Oh my goodness. Okay. Oh, we got another one. Congrats on reaching 700 subscribers. Thank you. I honestly couldn't have gotten this far without you guys. And special thanks to my Patreon subscribers. They've helped me a lot. They've helped me gain confidence in what I do. So, thank you, guys. Okay, would you be interested in doing collabs for audios? Yeah, I actually opened up commissions for scripts, as you know. By the way, our script that we did together was pretty fun. So, yeah, hopefully, like, I'll get some more collaborations, but with my fanfictions that I'm working on, as well as my debut novel, who knows? We'll see. Okay, also, wolf girls or cat girls? I'm a dog person. I will tell you straight, I am a dog person. So I'd have to go with wolf girls, though cat girls are really cute too. Actually, I'm going to tell you guys something. A couple months ago, I decided to watch the movie Cats. Yep, Cats. You know, the one that everybody talked about. But even though some things were very questionable about that movie, I actually really loved it. So, yeah, cat girls. Yeah, I'll probably do a cat girl audio in the future based off of that movie. Okay, what's my favorite audio I've done so far? Honestly, I can't give you a straight answer because at first I was like, no, I don't like any of these. I think, yeah. But I think the best one I did, my favorite, most favorite one, was the very first audio I did. The very first. It was based on the show that's on Netflix. It's called Cursed. think it's sort of a retelling of sort of Arthurian legend, where Nimue's, Lady of the Lake, she's the main character. It's pretty good, actually. Though, if you're not into things with a lot of violence and that, then probably it's not your thing, but I think it's pretty good. Okay. We have three people here. Hello, people. Okay. So, as I said, this is my first live stream, so if there are any awkward silences, then please don't mind. Okay, would you consider doing improv audios? Yeah, I think that would be pretty fun, though I think there'd be a lot of bloopers. There'd be a lot of bloopers. Okay, do you have any favorite voice actors from anime or animated shows? I'll be honest with you, I don't watch a lot of animated programs. I mostly watch live action, but there are a lot of animated movies that I like. I'm trying to think of one that I loved when I was little. You know what? My favorite voice actor when I was a child, and I will tell you this, was Antonio Banderas from Shrek. Yeah. I loved Shrek when I was a child. Like, first time I saw it, I did not like it for some reason. I did not like it. But I went to see the movie Puss in Boots in theaters with my family, and it was pretty good. They're making a sequel, actually, which I'm looking forward to. Even though the animation's different, I don't know why they made it different. Personally, I was surprised, but the story's really good, so of course I'll give it a watch. Okay, from anime, I don't really have a favorite anime actor, but I do have a lot of animes that I can recommend. My favorite anime is Violet Evergarden. Hands down. My brother actually recommended it to me, and I thought, okay. But as soon as I watched it, I was blown away. Blown away. It's pretty sad because it is based in wartime, but it's a fictional wartime. It's a fictional world. Like, the world building is amazing, the plot. It just grips you. Another favorite anime of mine is Moriarty the Patriot, which, if you know me, I basically love anything Sherlock Holmes related. So, if you're looking for a good Sherlock Holmes anime, may I recommend that? Okay, favorite movie of all time? Oh my goodness, this is the hardest question I've ever gotten. Yours is Jurassic Park. Oh, I love Jurassic Park. They're making a new one, by the way. Did you see the trailer? It looks amazing. And Jeff Goldblum is great. Absolutely. You should watch him in Thor Ragnarok. He's hilarious. Okay, favorite movie. Having to choose my favorite movie is like having to choose between a child or my favorite book, which I can't choose. But there are a lot of good ones that are at the top of my list. I actually watched Moulin Rouge this week for the first time. Well, actually, I watched it last week for the first time, and holy cow. I did not think I would like it because if you've seen the movie or if you haven't, I will just warn you, the beginning is a little strange. But as you get into it, it's actually a really good movie. The plot, the characters, I could go on about the characters forever, but I won't because then I don't want to spoil it. Also, I saw Cyrano. Oh, don't get me started on Cyrano. It was pretty good too. Oh, Moulin Rouge is cool. Yes. Okay, so I also love Sherlock Holmes with Robert Downey Jr. I like Pirates of the Caribbean. I like Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit. Anything that takes place in a different time period or anything based on like something historical, I will watch. I will watch it. Okay. What's your favorite holiday? Christmas. I love Christmas because it's snowing outside. Well, it doesn't always snow here in Canada, contrary to popular belief. Sometimes we don't get snow till like January, and then the snow may last until like April. I know it's strange, but Christmas is a great time. Yeah, Lord of the Rings is great. We still quote it to this day. Well, that's pretty good that you can quote it. Okay. Right, which one of the Lord of the Rings trilogy do you like the most? I think I like the last one the best. I like Return of the King. Because I love all the actors on screen together. Yes. I love seeing all of them too. All right. Okay, have you ever watched CG animated shows? I don't think. Ruby, I haven't seen that one. I've heard about it. But I haven't seen it. I have not seen that one. Some of the shows that I've been watching lately are Elementary, because of course Sherlock. And then on Tuesdays and Wednesdays, I usually will watch a movie with my mom. And then Thursdays. Oh, we watch this show Moon Knight. Have you guys ever heard of Moon Knight? It's Marvel. It's Marvel. It's really good. Okay, what type of music do you listen to? Mostly movie soundtracks. I actually just listened to the soundtrack for Moulin Rouge today. Or sometimes I will listen to Adele, or I'll listen to basically anything that pops into my head, I'll listen to it. Which is why I love the movie Guardians of the Galaxy, because it has a bunch of old songs that I like. Okay. Yeah, oh, did I mention Marvel? Avengers. I love the Avengers movies. We went to see Endgame in theater. It was great. Oh, and Star Wars. How did I forget Star Wars? We saw the last two in theaters. We saw The Last Jedi and we saw The Rise of Skywalker. It was great. There are a couple other movies that I want to check off my list. I want to watch House of Gucci. I want to watch. Oh, what else? What else? What else? My mind's drawn a blank. It happens so many times. I want to see the new Fantastic Beasts movie. That looks incredible. I want to see the new Jurassic World, as I've said. I want to watch. Don't know. I can't think of the movies on my list right now. I have a list of movies that I want to see. Okay. Do 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 do. Okay, just saw the new Batman film. Oh my goodness. You know, we're gonna wait until Batman comes out to, DVD or like Amazon Prime or something, because I haven't really been to a theater or anywhere since COVID. The last movie I saw in a theater before COVID was Sonic the Hedgehog. Yeah, that was the last one we saw, and then the pandemic hit, so we haven't really gone to a theater or anywhere else since then, just because we want to be on the safe side. Okay, if you like comic book based movie, Watchmen is really great. Watchmen, I know that name, but I don't. Yeah, I don't think I've seen that one. I don't think I've seen that. It's amazing. It's really dark, but it's really worth checking out. When it comes to dark movies, it's sort of a wait and see. Like, if it's too dark, then I won't watch. But Okay, so far this has gone really well. It's gone really well for my first time. What's your ring? Okay, are there any tips you have for anyone wanting to start their own ASMR audio roleplay channel? That's a good question. I'd say just go for it, because the longer you worry about it, the more you think, no, this isn't gonna work, or I'm not gonna be good enough, the more you're held back and the more difficult it will be to get out there. So I'd say just go for it. I mean, this is the right place to start. I mean, people will come and listen to you, and my channel has been very supportive. There haven't been any negative comments on my videos or anything like that. So, yeah. I say just go for it. Right, do you play video games? No, I don't actually play video games. The only game that I play is Minecraft on creative mode. Yeah, I'm not a big gamer. I used to play like Pac-Man and that when I was little, but not so much now. Favorite book? Oh goodness. Okay, if I had to choose a favorite book, it would be The Fault in Our Stars. The ending's sad, but it's definitely worth a read. It's worth a watch too. The movie is great. Though I haven't seen the movie in a very long time because, as I've said, it's very, very sad. My favorite books when I was a child were a lot different than the books I like now. I read Anne of Green Gables, I read Little Princess, Secret Garden, just the classics. I tried to read Pride and Prejudice because, you know, I like that sort of thing. But it's written in old-timey English, so it's a little hard to understand. Okay, a bit random, but what's the most annoying thing in Canada? Most annoying thing about living in Canada right now are the people complaining about masks. No, okay. Actually, the most annoying thing is basically in the winter, there really isn't a lot of snow, which I kind of find ironic because a lot of people think that if you move up to Canada, you'll see a bunch of snow, but also, other than that, living in Canada isn't that bad. I mean, I can't picture myself living anywhere else at the moment, but in the future, once things calm down a little bit, I would absolutely love to go to Scotland and the Netherlands because I actually have heritage there. I have ancestors who came from there, so that'd be really fun. I'd like to travel when things, like, not right now, but in the future. Thoughts on new Pixar's movie Turning Red? I actually kind of enjoyed Turning Red because like any Pixar movie, it did have a lot of emotion, and it was actually kind of funny seeing how some of the things were portrayed. Like, there are a lot of sort of hidden metaphors in there, or hidden meanings. Sorry. Set in Canada, yeah. It's actually set in Toronto, which is not that far away from where we live. My Canadian colleagues are complaining about being snowed in, having to shovel it out. Well, sometimes it snows a lot, but not always. And if it does, it lasts until the end of April. So, yeah, I think it all depends on how cold it is and if Mother Nature decides to let it snow, then it will snow. But when we talk about white Christmases, last year we didn't get snow for Christmas. We didn't the year before, but I remember when it did snow, and that was in 2013 when Frozen came out. If you could travel anywhere in the world, where would you like to go? But you can't travel back where you came from. Oh, that's a good one. Like I said, I would either go to the Netherlands or Scotland. I think out of all of them, it would be Scotland because they have such a rich history there. And like I can just imagine myself living there, maybe writing a book or two, and it would be nice. Be nice and quiet and peaceful. Preferably somewhere where there are woodlands, or if there are like a river or a lake. I would love to just live there. But yeah, that's actually a very good question. Speaking of writing, will you let us write your novels? Maybe. Maybe. Oh, let you read your novels. Okay, I thought you said write my novels. So I'm like, I kind of want to do that. But yeah, definitely when it comes out. What are your thoughts on furries and anthropomorphic characters? Well, like I said, I saw the movie Cats. And it was pretty good, so I have nothing to complain about them. Okay? Let them do their thing. Sorry about that. That was my headphones. Plus, I also saw Zootopia. So, if it's like in Zootopia or in Cats or whatever, then yeah, I'm perfectly fine with it. I love all your questions, guys. They're actually really good. They're really thought-provoking. But as far as my novels go, I only have one that I'm working on right now. I'm the kind of person who, like, you guys know this from my audience. I'm the type of person who will write one book at a time, or I will focus on a bunch of them at one time. Because I am working on two fan fictions. Well, actually, three, counting the Cats one I'm writing. Yeah, but you never thought in a million years you would meet someone who likes the movie Cats, but here we are. I'm also working on a fan fiction for Pirates of the Caribbean, like I said, and I'm working on a fan fiction for the movie Aragon. You guys have seen Aragon? It's great. My stomach, a little growl there. Okay, ooh, Cats fanfic. That'll be interesting to read. Yeah, it's on Archive of Our Own. Hold on, I will actually find the link to my. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I will find my account here. Where you guys can take a look at my writing. Aragon wasn't bad. I loved the books as a kid. Yeah, I actually read the books once. I haven't read them in a while, but okay, so yeah. This is my alt account, by the way. I have to be on here to see my questions. Okay, I read the Aragon books. Very nice. I like the movie, but it did take a lot of liberties. Yeah, I think if maybe they had enough money for a sequel, or they had enough money to continue the series, then they probably could have stretched it out a little more, included a little more things that were in the books. But it's a great movie anyway, you know? What made you choose the name White Wolf? Actually, it was inspired by The Witcher. I haven't seen The Witcher, but I know enough about it to probably tell you a little bit about it. I know the characters and some of the songs, but that's it. Okay, if you liked Zootopia, I'd recommend Anime Beastars. I have heard of that. I have heard of that show. It's a bit violent, though. Yeah. Yeah. If I know what to expect, then it's fine. But yeah. But yeah. Speaking of animated shows, we go, just tracking back to one of the questions one of you guys asked me. I did love The Dragon Prince. That's on Netflix. I did love that. Though I don't know if they're making a next season or not, because there was a little bit of stuff behind the scenes that people needed to deal with, so We'll see. We'll see. Okay, so have you read the Wheel of Time series? It's supposed to be really good, but I haven't read it or watched the series. Have not. I kind of wanted to, but it's so long. Yeah. I don't mind reading long series of books. Okay, Last Airbender. Oh my goodness, yes. Do you remember that one episode of Iroh? You guys remember that one? When he sings "Leaves from the Vine." Oh, that I watched it once and I cried, and then I watched it quite a while later. And I forgot how everything's going. Hello, After the Dawn. Everything's going great. Thank you for popping in. Is a Q&A. If you have any questions, just go ahead and ask them. Yes, I definitely recommend The Last Airbender series. You guys know they made a live-action movie, right? Yeah. I was surprised they made a live action series or a movie. Okay. Oh, he sings in front of the sun. Yeah. You know what? That was actually the voice actor's last time acting. He passed away, sadly. And you could just hear the emotion in his voice. It wasn't just because of the scene that he was doing. It was sad because he knew that this would be the last time. So, yeah. Have you seen The Matrix? I watched it once. I'll admit it wasn't really my thing, but hopefully we'll give the next Matrix movie a watch just because Keanu Reeves is in it and he's pretty good when he acts. Avatar live action, what? Yeah, I will say it's not as good as the animated series, mostly because, like the Aragorn movie, and there was a lot of stuff that they didn't include, and because it didn't make as much money as they hoped, then they didn't make a sequel. So, yeah. I didn't know that. Yeah, I know. It was the. I think not that long ago I found that out. And it made it so much sadder. There's no live action Last Airbender. Yes, exactly. Exactly. But yeah, definitely recommend that show, Last Airbender. Okay, super cool. Yes, this has now become a live action Avatar roast chat. And I'm loving that. Hold on. How do I? There we go. Thought I'd show a picture of my dog. Sorry about that, you guys. We had a little bit of a predicament. My dog had to go to the bathroom, so. Yeah, typical dog thing. Typical dog things. Okay. 1 second. And I'm back. Alrighty, guys. How we doing? I'm back, you guys. I'm back. Yeah, we had a little bit of a predicament. My dog had to go to the bathroom. Anyway, thank you. Welcome back. Yeah. I was making sure I wasn't tripping. Okay. That's cool. I love that. Okay. That's so funny. That's funny, you guys. Okay. So. Let's see, what did I miss? Okay, still talking about Airbender. Okay, Korra wasn't so bad, but not enough to hear. Yeah. I honestly don't remember Legend of Korra very much, if I'm being honest. If I had to choose between Last Airbender and that, it would be Last Airbender all the way. Okay. I wonder if she can do a Nazgul screech. No, not without hurting my throat, I can't. Or without hurting you guys' eardrums. No, I cannot do that. Okay. Have you seen A Little Battle Angel? Yes, I did. I did enjoy the Alita Last Battle Angel. I watched it the Last Battle Angel. Yeah, she is the Last Battle Angel. James Cameron and Robert Rodriguez. Yes, I did watch it. I loved it. I like that movie. I like that movie. I haven't seen the show or read the manga series, but I watched the movie. Mm-hmm. My girl Toph made up for it. Yes, I love Toph. Okay, gotta go now. Oh, bye. Nice to have you here. Alita was a good movie. Yep, absolutely. It was a great movie. Okay, Ding looks like I missed most of the stream. Well, mostly we've been talking about Last Airbender and Alita: Battle Angel, but okay, can you do a Professor Snape impression?
Turn to page 394.
Oh, no. That was bad. Like, only the Alan Rickman could do Professor Snape. No one else could. No one else can. Okay. Ha, Snape. Yeah. Okay. That always gets them. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, speaking of which, how do you guys feel about the new Fantastic Beasts movie? Can you do Christopher Walken? No! I have not seen any Christopher Walken movies, you guys. I'm sorry to disappoint you. I have not seen any Christopher Walken movies. Okay, have you talked about the novel you're working on? Yeah. I haven't mentioned very much about it, but basically it's about this girl who leaves the street life of London behind and goes to live with her grandfather in Ireland. He lives in this estate or castle, if you will. And in this castle, there's a library which has a secret door to the country air, which is supposed to be like air as in Ireland. That's kind of where I got the name. And then, and she basically has to claim this, her kingdom back from her crazy uncle. I know it's always the uncle, right? I did his voice while reading it, Green Eggs and Ham. It's pretty funny. But yeah, so far I have almost 112,000 words and counting. And I hope to finish it by the end of the year. Maybe afterwards, get an editor. And then a cover artist. And hopefully soon it'll actually be ready for you guys to read. Your story sounds like it'll be great. Thanks. I'm actually looking forward to everyone's reactions. Yeah. Yeah. Do 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 do. Okay. There we go. Sorry about that. Looking forward to it. Yay! Thanks. Also, I'm sorry if I keep staying on this screen. I don't really know what else I want to do. Okay, I think we're gonna wrap it up in a little bit, but do you guys have any more questions you want to ask me before we wrap it up? Okay, which of your characters' voices are the hardest to play? Actually, a lot of them. A lot of them are the hardest to play, which is why I practice a lot before I record. But I try to keep the same kind of voice for each character. Actually, if an audio a little while back, I tried to do a British accent. Okay. Oh, any planned sequels or prequels for any of your stories? Yeah, I actually have some audios for my vampire series coming up. I want to do a couple more movie-inspired audios. So, we'll see how that goes. The book was my main question for now. Enjoying your content, keep it up. Thank you! Okay, yeah, I'm looking forward to sharing my book with you guys. I think it'll be great. Okay, well, I gotta jump out now. Oh, it was very nice to see you. Okay, what's the highest and lowest your voice can go? Oh, okay.
I can talk like this. I can talk like this. Like a little, I don't know.
And I can talk like this, but it's kind of hurting my voice, so.
I can also do a nice Batman impression. Yeah.
I can also kind of do a chipmunk, but I guess the chipmunk one isn't really that
good. Ooh. I can't go too high without helium. Your squeaky voice needs to make an appearance in a future audio. Okay, I'll keep that in mind, I guess. I will keep that in mind. Oh, it's actually pretty nice, Batman.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you like it.
I can also do Surfer Dude. Yeah. So, dude. What else can I do?
This is my British accent. I don't know if it's 100% accurate or not. Kind of sound like Hermione right now. Sound like Hermione Granger.
Yeah. And I can also do this voice, like, I don't really know what kind of voice this is, but, yeah. I can also do this voice. I don't know what kind of voice this is either, but yeah.
Potential Hermione audio. Yeah, I'll definitely keep that in mind. Hermione audio. I'd love to do Hermione audio. Maybe I'll do that when the new Fantastic Beasts movie comes out. I'm looking forward to seeing that. But yeah, I'm hoping to do a lot of movie-inspired audios soon. So, yeah. British accent audio. I think I need to work on it a little more, but I think I will do some sort of British accent audio. I think that would go with Hermione, though. That would go with Hermione Granger. Oh, Scottish accent. Let me think of a line I can do from Brave. Okay, let me think for a second. Mom, it's just my bowl. Ah, but the princess should not have weapons, in your opinion. Yeah, I kind of need to work on that one a little more, but I think it's pretty good. I actually tried to read the junior novel of Brave in a Scottish accent. I used to be able to do it a little better, but I can't really do it right now, but perhaps if I work on it a little bit.
Your natural accent's so southern.
Yeah. Yeah, I know I can do a bit of a southern accent, I guess. Sort of my cowgirl, southern belle.
If I had to guess, says about like a true Canadian.
Yeah, everyone thinks we use the term a boot, which is about, but I've not heard one person say a boot. About.
Yeah, that's my southern Canadian.
It's not far off, actually. I'm from Ontario, which, if we remember our little discussion of turning red, Toronto's actually like 2 hours away from here. So, it's pretty cool that we get a Disney movie in Canada.
Okay, definitely not a boot, more like a boat.
Yeah, a boat, yeah.
A boot. I don't know what a boot is.
What other impressions?
As a Canadian, what's your opinion on Scott Pilgrim?
I don't know enough about Scott Pilgrim to have an opinion, if I'm being truly honest with you guys. Though if we want to talk about Ryan Reynolds, then yes, I have a very high opinion of him. He's Canadian.
I was only 1,500 miles off, lol.
Yeah. Okay. Da 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 da. All right, I think I have time for a few more, so.
Okay, Robin from here. Oh, I met your mother.
Oh my goodness, it only took me like a second to get that abbreviation. It's Canadian, I just remembered that. I never seen that show. I've never seen it. Like, I don't know if that's where Neil Patrick Harris got his start. But yeah. Oh, have you seen him in a series of unfortunate events? I loved that show with all my heart. Yeah. Streaming series actually do have a lot of good shows. His Dark Materials is great. Series of Unfortunate Events is great, and you'll be surprised to hear that I like
Carnival Row. Yeah, Carnival Row's pretty good. He wasn't a bad choice for that show. Yeah, I know. Like, don't get me wrong, Jim Carrey does a wonderful Count Olaf, but I think the series is more comedic, so they want a more comedic Count Olaf. Yes, you made a great one. Yes, absolutely. Like, I think Jim Carrey's was more, like, sinister and sort of the dark version, while we have the light version, who is also kind of sus. Yeah. But the series is great. I definitely recommend. Definitely recommend it. Yeah. So I think I have time for a few more questions before I have to wrap it up. Do you write in the mornings or at night? I tend to write more at night because it's when I have the most inspiration. Like, if I'm watching a movie and something strikes me, then I will write. Or in the mornings, I'll write. But I do a little bit of work in the mornings, so it's easier when I sit down in the evening and do it. So, yeah. If you do get into anime, Toradora is a good choice. I've never heard of Toradora. I'll have to look into it. The light novels anime is based off are even better. I will definitely look into Toradora and see. Your favorite author? Ooh, okay, that's another good one. I'm actually reading a fantasy series called Folk of the Air. So she has three books in this series, Holly Black. It's The Cruel Prince, The Wicked King, and Queen of Nothing. I'd have to say that her world building is amazing. I also like Lucy Maud Montgomery, who's also Canadian, who wrote Anne of Green Gables. I mean, she'll always be up there, my favorite authors. To be honest, I don't really have a favorite author. It's mostly books that I like, but if there's a book that I like, then I will certainly look into the author and see what else they've written. Do you like detailed outlines or jump into writing? I like to sort of plan it out, but if time is short and I need to get an audio out there, then I will sort of be spontaneous and just write whatever. And then I can always edit it later. It's sort of like when I'm writing my book, I'll just jot down whatever. Even if it doesn't make sense at first, I can always make it make sense later when I do the editing. What's the most embarrassing fanfiction you've ever written? I did send the link to my archive of our own. It has my very first Pirates of the Caribbean fanfiction on there, if I could turn back time. It was my very first ever fanfiction, and I mean ever, ever. So, yeah. Well, it's been really nice doing this live stream. I hope to do it again soon. Unfortunately, I need to wrap it up because the computer that I'm reading the questions off of is going to hibernate. So, with that said, I'll see you guys in the next video, which will be out next week, next Monday, usual time.
And hopefully we can do this again. So, bye.